Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, we're going to look at one of the more advanced features in Dashpivot. It's called list deployment, and it allows you to use different lists within a single template across your projects. So this comes in handy when you have a standard company template, for example, a daily report. And that daily report might use lists of people, subcontractors, cost codes, different companies. But those lists might be different from project to project. So you might want to use the same daily report across multiple projects, but each project is going to have a different list of people, a different list of cost codes, a different list of subcontractors, and you don't want to have to duplicate your daily report template across each project and have to set everything up from scratch. So what the list deployment allows you to do is take the same list framework and use that across all projects, but customize what items appear in each of those lists on each project. And so this way, your team can use the same template for every project, but utilize project-specific values. So we're going to run through a couple of diagrams just to explain this concept, and then we're going to jump into Dashpivot and build an example together. So before we start, it's important to note that the list deployment feature only applies to lists that exist in your list library, which are linked to templates in your template library. So when we set up a template at the company level and link it to a list, so let's say we have a site diary and we link it to a list of people. When we deploy out that template to one of our project teams so that it can be used out in the field. If it's linked to this list, it's actually going to show us all of the values that exist in that list. So if it's a list of people and there's 100 people in that list, then when we go to fill it out, we're going to have a dropdown that has up to 100 people in that list. But let's say on this project, only 20 of those people are actually relevant to this particular project. What we can do is we can take this list, we can deploy it out to our project as a what's called a child list, and then we can build that child list to only include, let's say, 20 people that exist in the parent list. So the parent list has 100 items, the child list might only have 20 of those items, and so when we're filling out our site diary, there will only be 20 people to choose from in our drop-down menu. And we can repeat this process over and over for each project, which means that each project will have its own list of 20 people or 30 people or 40 people or everyone that's on that list. You've got the flexibility to choose what values should appear on each project. So here we are inside of Dashpivot. And we're in an organization that has three projects. And each of these projects has several teams. What we're going to do is set up a site diary at a company level. So within our template library, we're going to deploy that across all of these teams so that the whole company will be using the same template. But at the same time, we're going to set up a list within our list library, which will be linked to our site diary. It's going to be a list of people, and we're going to deploy that list to each of these three projects. And then once we've done that, we will customize that child list within each project to have only a subset of all of the people that are listed at a company level. And what this means is that any teams that sit below that project, when you go to fill out a site diary, you won't see all of the values that exist at the company level. You'll only see the list items that have been configured at a project level within that child list. So this will all make sense in a couple of minutes, but just wanted to explain that that's what we're going to be covering. So let's get started. So we're going to start off in the list library at the company level, and we're going to create a list. And then we're going to go to our template library and link the two together. So let's create a list. Let's call it people. And we're going to add a couple of items. We're going to have Sam, Lance, Shelley, Hartley, and Ed. So we have five items in our list, and we're going to link this list to a site diary template. So let's go to the templates section. And in our template library, we have just the one template here. It's our site diary, ready to go. And if we select it and click edit, this diary has a table for tracking labor. And at the moment, we have a column where we can enter the people, or let's change that to name. And at the moment, it's just a text input. So you'd have to type in someone's name every time. We don't want that. We want to make this faster to fill out. So we're going to refer to a list that we have. So let's select list, and we're going to link it to the list that we just set up. So we're going to select the list of people. Great. So now that we've done that, we're going to save this template. And so all that we've done is link our template that lives in our template library to our list, which lives in our list library. So it means that if we now deploy this template, whenever we go to fill out one of these site diaries, it's going to use our list of people, and it's going to show up all values that exist in the list. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's deploy this template out. So select it, then click Manage Deployment, and you can see the projects and teams here. I'm going to select all of these projects, click Save, and let's go into this first site team underneath this first project here, and go to Templates, and we can see we've got our site diary. So it's ready to go. Let's click on it, and let's add a new diary. So we have the whole form. I'm not going to fill out the whole thing. I'm just going to skip ahead and draw your attention to this table here where we are utilizing the list that we set up. So you can see all of the people's names listed here. And we could go ahead and pick someone's name. Let's say Sam. But you'll notice that all five of the options appear here. Now we can save that, and we can see that we've got our form here. But what if only a few people need to appear on that list? So we don't want all five, maybe we only want two. Well, what we need to do is deploy that list to this project and then make some changes to that child list which is deployed. So let's go back to the company. Let's go to the list library, select our list, and click Manage Deployment. Now this time, we're going to deploy it to all our projects, but we'll focus on Kensington Road. Save the deployment, and let's go to the site team, we'll go to the project and go to the list section. So here we have our child list, and when we first deploy it, it's actually going to be empty. So we have five items in our company list in the parent. We've deployed it, so now we're looking at the child, but there's no values in here yet. We have to choose what values we want to include or add new ones. So let's select it, and let's add a few items. Let's add a few people. Let's add Lance and Sam and let's now add Shelley and someone new. Let's add in Tim. But Tim doesn't already exist in our parent list. So by adding in Tim, we're adding him to the child list, but also to the parent list, which means that other projects can potentially use this list item elsewhere. So to show you what I mean, we now have these four values here. So four values in the child list. But if we go back to the company level and go to the list section, you can see that there's now six. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and you can see Tim has been added on the end there. So we have all of our values, all of our list items here, but within this project, we only have 4. Now, if we go to the next project and go to the list section, we have another child list that is just for this project. And if we click on it, we can add some new items, including Tim, who's now on our parent list. So we can add him in. And so every time we go to add, we're really just running a search. And if it doesn't already exist, we can add a new item to the list. So this is great. So now we have 2 items on the list in this project. And I just want to show you that if we now go to one of these site teams and go to the template section and now go to fill out one of our diaries, in the drop-down list, there's now only going to be the items to select that exist in that deployed child list. So this is really good. We have project-specific values appearing in each of our projects. And just to finish off this example, let's customize the deployed list for the last project. Go to the list section, click on it, click add item, and this time we're just going to add completely new names in here. So we have 2 completely new names. Now, one thing to note here is that if we delete these list items, they will be removed from the list at the project level, but at a company level, they will still exist on the parent, because as soon as we add them at the project level to the child list, they automatically get added to the company parent list. So I'll show you what I mean. So let's say that we delete Danny. Now it's been removed, but if we go to the company and go to the list library, you'll see that we have both Amy and Danny on that list. So we have all the items here. So if we wanted to remove Danny completely from this list, it can only be done at a company level. And if we do delete any of the list items from within our list library at the company level, it will remove that list item from all of the child lists as well. And this is something that only organization controllers have the permission to do, because only organization controllers can access the organization list library and template library. Now, I should say that you can undeploy lists. So if we select our list and click on Manage Deployment, we can undeploy a list. All it means is that if we now go to the team and go to fill out one of our site diaries, this time when we go to do it, it's going to have all the values in that parent list. So you can see it's got all of the values here, including Danny, which was deleted from one of the other project, or removed, I should say. Not deleted. So if a list has not been deployed to a project, by default it will use all the values in the parent list. Now, a few things just to finish up. It is possible for the child list on multiple projects to use the same unique list item. So what this means is that if we add a list item in one project, for example, we added Tim before. This list item then becomes available to be added to any of the other child lists across any other project. And this is important for data quality, especially for any analytics charts that you have, or if you wanted to run a search at a later date. You don't want to have 20 different Tims in this list. You just want to have the one, if we're talking about one person. So it keeps everything nice and clean, data-wise. Just a note on the list properties. So any properties that are configured on the parent list, so if we have a list of people and we have columns for their date of birth, their emergency contact, their phone number, this type of thing. Those property columns will appear in all of the child lists, and any of the values that are added at a company level will also be populated within those project child lists. The property values themselves, so for example, a person's phone number or emergency contact, currently aren't able to be modified or changed at the project level. But as a side note, this will be possible in future. And in doing so, by modifying the list property at a project level, you will also update that property value at the company level. So let's say, for example, we have Tim as an example, a list item for Tim, and he's been added to two projects. If we change the property of Tim's phone number in one project, it will update in the other project and update at the within the parent list as well. So if you update it in one place, it will update everywhere else that list item is being referenced. Again, this just keeps all of the data clean across your Dashpivot account. And one final note on list deployment. Instead of coming into the list section and selecting the list and clicking Manage Deployment and then choosing which projects you want to deploy that list to, if you know that every single time you have a new project that you will want to build a project-specific list, there is a shortcut. If we go back to the template library and open up the template builder, where we specify this list, we can click this auto deploy child list button here. And what that means is every single time we create a new project that uses this site diary template, that list of people will automatically be deployed to the project. But just be aware that whenever a list is deployed initially, it will be blank. So you will need to go into the project and configure that list before any of the values will actually appear in the drop-down menu. And one interesting scenario to consider is if you have a single list, so a list of people being referred to in multiple templates, so a template for your site diary, a template for your weekly inspection, an incident report, and so on. If all three or more of those templates all referred back to the same project list, well, if you're using all three of those templates on multiple projects and a list is deployed, that list of people, if that was deployed to the project, then all three of those templates will refer to the deployed list rather than the list in the list library, the parent. So that concludes this video. I hope that it's been useful. Additional resources are available in our help article on list deployment. And if you get stuck, you can always reach us via live chat, via the website, or via the mobile app. And as always, thanks for watching.